Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Hi, Sarah.
Teresa, you haven't been a good girl today. You're gonna go to bed.
Hey, Evelyn. Hi, honey. Wendy's here. Got Wendy. Car's outside. How you feeling? You okay?
Yeah.
All right. You want me to pack up a suitcase? Anything else to go in here? You all right?
I'm fine. I'm not gonna have the baby right now.
All right. I just don't want to play doctor on the way out.
I know.
Sure you're all right?
I'm fine.
Sure. Yeah. Absolutely sure.
Okay. Here we go.
All right. Sure you're all right?
I'm fine.
Here, let me go first. Stairs. Hold on, why don't you just come on? Yeah, that's right. I heard two of them. Come on.
Hi, Ben.
Hi.
Listen, there's chicken on the counter for supper.
Okay.
I made some fresh banana bread that you can eat.
And you can eat.
Bedtime, 8 o'clock.
Okay, bye-bye.
Okay, you're hugging a kiss.
Say bye-bye, Mommy.
Wish me luck.
Come on, Mommy. Mommy, come on.
Okay, think of some names, all right? For a boy? Good luck.
Bye, Wendy.
Bye.
Bye, darling.
Hey, come on.
We're
gonna
be all right.
Let me take my arm here.
Oh.
Okay, come on.
Sorry.
Okay, just relax, okay? All right, no, I'll get the
door.
Yeah, no, I already
had it. Okay, you all right? It's a boy. Congratulations. Here is a wish come true.
Oh, thanks.
Don't hurt you.
She's fine.
That's okay.
Oh, look, he's got a grip already.
That's
wonderful.
We'll just get him cleaned up a little now and make him presentable for Mommy. There you go.
Continue the cleanup, and I'll do a further examination in a moment.
What?
Oh, I was wondering if we got any scotch in the house.
Did you want chips, Maggie? Mm-hmm. Ooh, fattening.
I think I know what to do with these.
What?
On the table.
That's it, David. Ooh, phone. Shh, quiet, everybody.
Keep it down, you guys. Listen to what the boss says.
Hi, are you finished? That long, huh? Okay, listen, I'll give you 5 minutes and I'm putting the dinner in the oven, okay? Okay, bye.
That was a fast delivery, Lenny. Did you thank the mother?
Yeah, it was fast, all right. Not exactly a day at the beach.
What's the matter?
Looks like I assisted in delivering my first downy.
Oh, that's too bad. Hey, Lenny, any idea where I can still buy some flowers tonight?
What are you looking for?
Roses. Just a couple roses.
Yeah, sure. Second floor. Lots of them.
Come off it. I can't go around stealing patients' roses.
So who said go out and steal them? Just ask. Women never turn down a doctor in love.
Thanks for the inspiration.
Take it from me, Barry. I've been in love many times.
Robarts, I'm afraid.
Yeah, I sensed that in the delivery room. He's retarded, isn't he?
I'm afraid it's Down syndrome, Mr.
Robarts. Oh, my God.
I'm really very sorry.
Oh, my God. Why me? Why ask? I mean, Judy doesn't smoke. She hasn't had a drink in 9 months. I mean, there's no history of this in our family. There's not. Why do we end up with a retarded child?
I honestly don't know, Mr. Robarts. We have all the latest tests, equipment, prenatal care. We have it all at our disposal, but we don't have all the answers as to why these things happen. He also suffers from internal problems, but we'll do a more thorough examination in the morning.
What do you mean, internal problems?
Well, he's suffering from a partial blockage of the bowel, and I'm afraid that only corrective surgery can alleviate that problem. Without the surgery, he won't make it.
You know, I can't believe this is happening to me. I don't know what to do.
My personal opinion in this case is to let nature take its course. We don't have to elect for surgery. We can prescribe drugs instead. We can keep him comfortable. We can keep him free from pain. We can keep him from suffering.
Well, I would prefer that. Thank you.
Mr. Robarts, just one little thing.
Oh, thank you.
Nice grass.
Thank you very much.
Mm. Oh, you didn't have to call. Oh, look at that camp. Someone smoking in here? Surprise! Oh, you guys. Congratulations, Doctor. Well done.
I haven't done anything.
Barry, this is just a small, intimate gathering in your honor to celebrate, whatever you guys call it.
Acceptance, Joan.
Thank you, Maggie. Acceptance at Chicago Children's
Hospital.
Hospital! Right!
I hear the nurses are pretty good, too.
Guess I'll just have to wait and see.
How about Joan? Is she going, too? I mean, are we going to lose a singleton or a pair?
Who knows? I don't tell them.
A little food, perhaps, gentlemen.
Thank you, Joe.
Joe says you're going to be a big city doctor.
The important thing, Judy, is to remember that there is no fault on your part or on Hank's. Yeah.
Evelyn.
She's fine.
Shh, shh. It's all right.
Are you tired?
No. Well, a bit.
Oh, you're not getting cranky now, are you?
No. It just dawned on me that in 2 weeks I'll be gone from here.
Oh, now don't you get mushy on me, mister.
Chicago just won't be the same without you.
I know, but you know I can't go right now.
There are literally hundreds of girls looking for someone to share an apartment with, and you have to pick Maggie.
Yeah, but the thing is, if I pull out now, she's going to be up the creek. We've already paid the deposit. I can't change my mind.
It's only money.
Oh, that's easy for you to say, doctor. Do you know any nurses with a healthy paycheck?
So you feel obliged to support Maggie's high living with your paycheck. Wonderful. What about me?
Well, how about this?
So, what do you think it's going to be?
A boy.
Yeah? Would you dress him?
No. I would have a girl instead.
Oh. Good morning, Mr. Robarts.
Good morning, Maggie. Hi, sweetheart.
Hi.
Kiss.
Is it a boy or a girl, Daddy?
Well, honey, you got yourself a little brother.
All right. Congratulations. Is something the matter?
Yeah, the baby's very sick, Wendy.
Don't worry. He'll get better.
I don't think so. He's retarded.
I'm sorry to hear that, Mr. Robarts.
What does retarded mean, Daddy?
There's no doubt in my mind the child has an incarcerated hernia. It's a minor problem, really. But I do think we should take care of it before we run into any further complications. What do you think? Maybe we could squeeze him in later today.
Dr. Nicholson, I'm afraid that the parents prefer no further treatment at this time.
What do you mean, no further treatment?
Well, under the circumstance, they prefer no operation.
Are you trying to tell me they want to deny him minor surgery because he's retarded?
Yes.
Oh, come off it, Doctor. I've never heard of anything so ridiculous in all my life. I mean, this isn't open-heart surgery. We're talking here about a minor but necessary procedure, nothing more.
Down syndrome, this congenital defect could be just the tip of the iceberg.
Don't tell me you agree with him.
Yes, I'm afraid I do. Raising a severely retarded child isn't everyone's cup of tea.
Are you advocating that we only practice routine medicine on healthy little doctors and lawyers?
You know better. What I'm suggesting...
Then why do you keep referring to the child as being severely retarded? You know as well as I do that at this stage we simply can't tell. He stands as good a chance to be only very mildly retarded.
Very mildly retarded. You want to treat the malady and ignore the patient. You can't force people to love something they don't want.
I see. Well, in that case, I have to tell you that I feel obligated to bring it to the attention of the Ethics Committee because, in my opinion, not treating this child would be a clear violation of the regulations we have here regarding treatment in cases such as this.
Sure. I understand.
Incarcerated hernia is only a minor procedure, isn't it, Bernie?
Oh, there's nothing to it, Bill. I mean, part of the kid's intestine is obstructed by being trapped in a congenital rupture sac. And all you do is cut the neck of the sac, relieve the obstruction. It's a very simple procedure. Mind you, you've got to act quickly, or you run the risk of gangrene. And then you really do have a mess in your hands.
Okay, I get the drift. Yeah, Nancy, get me John Titleman, will you? I think we should get a court hearing on this. This is too big just to sweep under the rug. You agree?
This is crazy, Bill.
John! Bill Thatcher, how are you? Listen, we got a bit of a problem here. No, this could be a sticky one.
Good morning, Robarts, Mason, Willoughby. No, I'm sorry, Mr. Robarts isn't in right now. Uh-huh. Yeah. Can you hang on for a moment, please?
Morning, Joanne. Yeah, any calls?
There's a Dr. Herford in the line for
me. On the line. Take it in my office. Morning, Dr. Herford. Robarts here. Look, I don't care how she feels. I mean, this is something that we have to live with for the rest of our lives. I mean, no, we just won't consent to an operation, that's all. Joanne, Bill isn't in, right?
No.
Okay, well, as soon as he comes in, I want to see him upstairs, okay?
Okay.
Thank you.
Good morning, Hank.
Bill, I need you.
Well, you need bailing out or what?
No. It's the baby. We got a problem. Come on.
Sure.
Hi, Auntie Helen.
Hi, John.
What you doing?
I'm planting bulbs. It's an amaryllis.
Not nice.
How's the party?
Oh, it was great, and everybody loved your potato salad.
Was Barry surprised?
Yeah, he was real surprised.
No, I mean, was he really, really surprised?
Yeah, he was really surprised. Honestly, he didn't suspect a thing. You should have seen his face. Oh, look, here. Postcard from Mom and Dad.
That's nice. Beautiful. Yeah. Oh.
Here, let me read it for you, okay? Hi, Helen and Joan. The weather's great. We had lots of fun, but we miss you both. See you next week. Love, Mom and Dad. Do you want to keep that?
I'm glad they're having a nice time.
Yeah, well, they'll be back in 6 days. You got a lot of bulbs there, huh?
The man in the flower store gave me all these. They're amaryllis, and they have to stay dormant in the basement in the summer. And you bring them up and put water on them, and up like that. Up. Big red flowers.
Ooh, isn't that nice? Huh? Oh, that's great. That garden's going to be beautiful, isn't it?
No, you keep them in the kitchen. In the winter, when that makes flowers in the
world. Oh, that's great. Look, I'm sorry. I got to go to work, okay? Now, I'm on the 3:30 to 12 o'clock shift, so don't you wait up for me, okay, hon?
Nope.
All right, see you later.
I know that. Just think I'm stupid or something.
Something in pink is quite
wrong. Well, pink would be the wrong color. Oh, no. No, and it's crooked. Look at it.
Hi.
What about something like this?
Huh? Yeah, nice to be young again, huh?
Well, it depends on how you look at it. I was always broke. Can't have much fun when you're broke all the time. Now I'm having fun.
Maybe.
Well, wait till you're married. I can wait. Sure.
Mr. Robarts, is this something I can help you with?
Yeah, I wonder if you could send some flowers to the hospital for my wife.
Sure, no problem. Anything in particular?
Well, no, I'll let you decide.
Okay, I know just the thing.
Great, thanks. Just put it on my bill.
Okay, no problem.
Thank
you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Perhaps down at the center table, Your Honor.
Before taking our seats, ladies and gentlemen, will those of you who know yourself to be witnesses, please raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear that the testimony you are about to give in cause of this action will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you, God?
I do.
I do.
I do.
Please be seated. I call this hearing to order. Mr. Titleman, you may proceed.
Thank you, Your Honor. Your Honor, I have requested this court hearing on behalf of Middleton Memorial Hospital. A conflict has arisen between Dr. Herford, the Robarts Child's obstetrician, and the pediatric medical staff of the hospital with regard to the continued medical care of the Robarts Child. The pediatric staff is of the opinion that without an immediate surgical procedure, the life of the child will be in serious jeopardy. Dr. Herford and the child's parents desire a diametrically opposed course of treatment, which will, in all likelihood, cause the hastened death of the infant. Now, since Dr. Herford has no pediatric privileges in Memorial Hospital, the hospital, for that reason, is requesting the court to make a ruling on this matter.
Very well. Thank you, Mr. Titleman. Mr. Meese, would you please make your case?
Thank you, Your Honor. I'd like to call Dr. James Herford to speak on my client's behalf.
Your Honor, at approximately 8:19 p.m. on the evening of November the 16th, a male infant was born to Judy Robarts in an uneventful delivery. Shortly thereafter, it became very apparent to me that the child suffered from Down syndrome with a further complication of an incarcerated hernia. I informed the father, Hank Robarts, of the situation. I outlined his options in this situation, the first which was to operate on the child. Mr. Robarts expressed that both he and his wife would strongly object to an operation and could not give their consent. Mr. Robarts and his wife both feel that a minimally acceptable quality of life is not present for a child suffering from severe mental retardation. The second course of treatment I outline consists of basic techniques administered to aid in keeping the child comfortable and free from pain. This morning, I consulted with pediatrician Dr. Nicholson, who has confirmed my findings and has prescribed the analgesic morphine in a dosage of 1 milligram QPD.
Oh, my dear, he's vomited again. I'll take care of it.
Thanks, Valerie.
Well, I'd like to take issue with Dr. Herford on two counts. First, the mental retardation question. It is absolutely impossible to determine the extent of the child's retardation at this early stage. During my 20 years as a physician, I can attest that the majority of Down syndrome children achieve a reasonable quality of life. One young man I know of with Down syndrome has written 3 books and speaks 2 languages. Certainly an academic feat not to be treated lightly. And secondly, I strongly disagree with Dr. Herford's course of treatment. It consists of basic techniques administered to aid in keeping the child comfortable and free from pain. In other words, painkillers, nothing more, and let nature do the rest. And that, in my book, is no treatment at all.
Hello? What's going on here?
Hi. We had a Downie last night that needs minor surgery. Parents don't want to bother with it.
Oh, I don't believe it.
They're having a court hearing in there right now to figure out how to go about it. I've never heard of anything like this before.
It is the opinion of this court that Mr. and Mrs. Robarts, after having been fully informed of the medical opinions of 2 sets of physicians, have the right to choose a medically recommended course of treatment for the child in the present circumstances. The court, being sufficiently advised, now directs the Middleton Memorial Hospital, its medical staff, and all other personnel to allow treatment as prescribed by Dr. Herford. And as directed by the parents for the infant robot.
Herford got his way. No food, water, intravenous whatsoever. Just morphine. And he calls that a course of treatment.
What's the matter with those people?
They just don't want the baby. That's all there is to it.
We'll disconnect the bag when it's empty. That'll make it a bit easier.
Yeah.
We gotta keep busy.
It wasn't just Herford, Joan. The parents made the final decision. Of course, Herford no doubt helped them along.
How could somebody do that to their child? I just can't fathom that.
Joan, listen to me. For your own good. Don't get yourself all worked up about this. You'll only drive yourself crazy.
It's very easy for you to say, Barry. Remember, all you guys have to do is write out the orders. We're the ones who have to carry them out. You have absolutely no idea what it's like to watch a baby die when you know you can do something about it.
What do you want me to do?
Thank you.
friend said she didn't even want the child near her. Can you believe that?
Oh, I don't know what to believe anymore. I don't think I can do it.
All right, then I'll do it.
Good night, Judy. Hank.
Thank you, Father. Good night. Elevator's, I think, to the left.
I wish I could die.
Come on, give me that. Up, you go. Look, I gotta tell you what happened today. There's some doctors at the hospital here who disagree with Dr. Herford's treatment of the boy.
Why?
The doctors here at the hospital want to operate on the boy, and Dr. Herford doesn't want to because he doesn't think it's going to accomplish anything.
But if an operation would make him better.
Yes. You see, that's the whole point, Judy. You can't ever make him better. I don't know. I just think it's better to let nature take its course. Let the poor little guy die in peace. Oh, God, this is hard.
Hello.
Just checking on how you're doing.
Oh, thanks. I think I'm okay now.
I miss you.
I miss you, too. Do you want to come over tomorrow night?
Sure. Meet you at the hospital?
No. Forget the hospital. Just come on over to my house.
Have good sleep.
Thanks. I could use that after all that rotten business today, I'll tell you. Yeah, I love you too, kid. Good night, Barry.
Good night, Joan.
Hi, Joan. Here's your tea. Is there something the matter?
I don't know, Aunt Helen. I'd like to move so far away from here, you have no idea.
Away from me? Oh, what would I do without you?
No, not you. No, it's just... Yeah, it's just everything. The hospital, everything. Even Barry.
I thought you liked Barry.
Yeah, I like Barry. It's just he's too young and he's getting too serious. It doesn't matter.
But you like the hospital. I never heard you talk like that before.
Yeah, well, there's a baby down there dying and they could do something about it.
Oh. I don't understand that.
Well, they refuse to operate.
Maybe they can't do the operation. Remember Uncle Joe?
Oh, yeah, I remember Uncle Joe, but this is different. They can do the operation. They just don't want to.
Why don't they want to do the operation?
Because the baby's retarded.
I still don't understand.
Yeah, well, maybe it's better you don't.
No, I guess there's a lot of things I don't understand. Come on, now, drink your tea, Joan. That'll make you feel better.
Listen, I have a chart on the arm, baby.
Yes, of course, doctor. There you go. Good afternoon, everybody. How are you?
Hi, good afternoon.
I'm glad to see you guys.
No, it's not.
What? It's cooking.
Robart's baby's in the linen closet.
What?
Mm-hmm. You'll find out why. Everything else is normal.
Glad you're just here. Believe it. See you.
Evening. Yeah,
I'll see you tomorrow.
We got enough this afternoon.
Oh,
he's doing
all right, isn't he?
Yeah.
Just keep him awake, okay? You're doing well. Due for a shot, huh?
Yeah. He nearly drove Audrey and Susan crazy last night with his constant cry. That's why they brought him in here.
Poor little guy.
Now look at that. His lips are still wet. How can that be possible?
I don't know. I'm afraid I'm not an expert at that kind of a thing.
Talk to Ralph. They can get us on a flight Sunday night. A couple of weeks in the sun, huh? Have some of those drinks with paper umbrellas in them, right?
Hmm? Oh, God, I miss Evelyn.
Yeah.
What did she say?
Well, I told her that her little brother was very sick and that he wouldn't be coming home. And she never said another word. Oh, she's got something for you. It's a picture of something.
Really?
Forgot to look at.
Gave him another shot.
Oh, yeah.
Still got that headache.
Yeah.
Why don't you take off? It's almost 12 and I can cover for you.
Really?
Sure.
You're a doll.
Thanks. No problem.
Okay. Fresh air will probably do me some good, too.
I'm sure.
Hi.
Hi. How goes the battle?
Well, it's all right, I guess, but this place has sure been giving me a headache lately, I can tell you.
You're not the only one, my dear.
Oh, look, Mary's gonna cover my report for me, okay?
Yeah, no problem, Joan.
Thanks. Hi, Hannah.
Good night.
Good night.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
So here's what's happening.
From the start with this baby, we're having some problems, and I don't know exactly.
Hiya, baby.
Hi.
What
Hi.
You doing?
Okay, hang on.
Going on here? You've taken that baby from the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
What's the matter with you?
Would you keep your voice down? If my aunt wakes up, we're really in trouble. Do me a favor and get me that coat rack, okay? And can you get me a coat hanger out of that cupboard over there? You're starving this baby to death, Barry.
I know. What can I do about it?
You could do an operation. That's what you can do about it. Thanks.
Try to understand, Joan. That child isn't my patient. I don't even have the right to interfere anymore with the court order and all that. Come on, be reasonable.
Well, what would you rather do? Stand by and do nothing while this child dies, or do something about it?
You don't understand. If I touch this child, I may as well forget about Chicago. My career, I'll be finished. I may as well renew my cab license.
Oh, come on, quit being so melodramatic.
You know, that's easy for you to say. I'm barely dry behind the ears, and you want to toss me into the ring with the medical establishment. Never mind the court order.
Well, you're a surgeon, aren't you?
Oh, yeah, sure. And what kind of fight do you think that's going to be? Me versus the old guard? And the winner is... Don't be so naive, Joan. They'll crucify me.
Well, if it comes to that, your word is as good as theirs. I mean, nobody in their right mind is going to let a baby die from an incarcerated hernia, Barry.
Of course not. But he's got Down syndrome, and that makes all the difference. To them, anyway.
You know, the hospital's on our side. They wanted to operate.
Sure, they wanted to operate. Now it's wanting to protect their reputations. Why do you think they request that court hearing? Because they were so much interested in this kid? Come off it. They just wanted to cover themselves. So don't give me that good Samaritan stuff.
Look, Barry, nobody will ever know you did it. It's only an incarcerated hernia.
Incarcerated hernia, all right. But by now it may be gangrenous. And if that's the case, we are in a mess.
He's barely 48 hours. And immediately after you do the operation, I'll get him back to the hospital. Nobody will ever know you did it.
You make it all sound so simple. Besides, where and with what do you propose I do this surgery? Mm. I'm afraid to ask you, but where?
In the kitchen.
The kitchen.
Well, the way my Aunt Helen cleans and scrubs the kitchen, it's as sterile as any doctor's office I know of. And they do operations.
You think there's a war going on here?
You know what? The Robarts baby is gone.
He gone?
He's not in the linen room.
Before we start, don't you think it's a good idea to wake up your aunt?
Well, don't worry about her. She sleeps like a log.
You sure we're doing the right thing?
Oh, God, I hope so.
Get the kid.
There's no entry. I can't believe it.
Everyone just buzzes up and doesn't tell us what's going on.
All right, let's call Mrs. Tingley. Friendly neighborhood supervisor. This should give her something to do.
Okay.
Give me the swab.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
anesthetic? Okay. Hold him really tight as he's gonna move, all right, Jack?
Okay. Okay, you're gonna be all right there, little guy.
Should give it a couple of minutes.
What are you doing?
Sleeps like a log, huh?
I'm sorry. Look, Aunt Helen, this is an emergency, but everything's all right. So you just sit down, honey. Sit down.
What are you doing with the baby?
We are trying to make this baby better, Aunt Helen. Please sit down and don't touch anything.
Okay, do what Barry says, honey. It's all right. Sit down.
Sit down, Aunt Helen. Please.
You don't have to get mad at me.
I'm not mad at you. Okay. Make the incision.
All right.
Hold them really tight.
Okay.
What are you doing to that baby? Look at him.
Aunt Helen, be quiet. Barry has to concentrate. Fine.
Good, it's bluish. I think we got it in time.
Good.
Why didn't you take him to the hospital?
Not yet. Okay. Okay, now look, I want to cut this tight ring now.
Okay.
Hold him really tight.
Right.
If I nick the bowel, we're in trouble.
Okay.
Look, he's turning pinker.
I don't understand you, too. Did you tell his mother and father you were going to do this?
All in good time. Okay, ready to close. Suit yourself.
God love you, Barry, you did it.
Probably my first and last. Be a little loose for this when I'm in jail.
Stop it.
Morning.
Morning.
In all my life, I've never encountered anything like this.
No, neither have I. But I've been thinking. And in my humble opinion, it's all rather simple.
And what does that mean?
Well, look at it this way. Why would anyone in the right mind take the Robarts child unless they were aware of his condition? And they didn't take a healthy baby from the nursery. They took the Robarts baby. So I think whoever it is was aware and wasn't exactly in agreement with your course of treatment. You think that's far-fetched?
I'm not sure. I certainly hope you're wrong.
Well, in any case, I'll have to get the police involved in this.
Do you think that's wise at this time? I mean, if your theory is...
Well, why not?
What you say makes a lot of sense. Chances are this whole business could clear itself up in a day or two. Bring the police in at this time could only make matters more messy for everyone concerned.
Well, especially you and the family.
I mean everyone concerned, including the family and the hospital.
Look, Dr. Herford, just worry about your patients and let me worry about the hospital. For 20 years we've kept our nose clean around here and I want to keep it that way.
Excluding the kidnapping of a child from your nursery?
Such a beautiful baby. Why didn't his mother love him?
know what Joan said? She says he looks a little bit like me.
I think she's right.
New baby?
Oh.
Now, will that be all?
Yeah, thanks.
All right. Have a nice day, eh?
Yeah, it's okay.
You must have cold feet like my wife. But a warm heart, I'm sure.
There's this too. I don't need a bag for that.
I'm sorry.
Good, you're back.
Yeah, I'm sorry I'm late. Is he all right?
He's fine. You got everything
okay.
We need?
Yeah, I'll get it ready.
Okay, I gotta run.
Okay, go. I'll see you tonight.
Absolutely.
Okay, bye. Hi. How's he doing?
Oh, he's a good boy.
Yeah.
He's wet.
Oh, well, I got diapers and everything. Here's the file. Did you need anything else?
No, thank you, Nancy. Just ask Mr. Roberts to come in, will you?
Okay, fine.
Yes, do come in, Mr. Roberts. We have a bit of a problem
here. Yes, I gathered that. It isn't my wife, is it? Something happened to Judy?
No, your wife is fine now. In fact, she should be ready to go home today. Hank, sit down.
Well, I hope we're not here to rehash the court case.
No, of course not.
Someone, Mr. Robarts, and we have no idea who, took your baby away from the hospital last night.
What do you mean? Somebody just walked in here and took a child?
Well, we don't precisely know how the child disappeared. All we know for certain is that the child has disappeared. The police have been called in to conduct an investigation.
This is unbelievable. Does my wife know?
Well, we're not sure. But as you can well imagine, this is so unusual that it'll be hard to keep the lid on it for very long. I am sorry, Mr. Roberts.
All right, listen, and you better get this straight, Thatcher. Under no circumstances do I or my wife want to be identified or involved in any of this. Now, this is gross negligence on the part of the hospital. So you better get yourself together because this is your problem.
Mr. Roberts, please.
I'm afraid all of this is going to be too much for your wife to handle. For her health's sake, I think it best that we get her out of this atmosphere as quickly as possible.
Yeah.
Why would anyone want to kidnap a dying baby?
Your guess is as good as mine, Bill.
Tell you the truth, babies all sort of look alike to me. I understand the baby wasn't well. It was kept separate from the other babies. Is that correct?
That's right.
Where was that?
In a room next to the nursery.
Do you mind showing us where that was?
Certainly.
Thank you.
Would you follow me, please? Yes. Mm-hmm.
Mrs. Tingley, is it normal routine to put sick kids in, what do you call this, a linen room?
No, officer, it isn't. But he was a screamer, and it can be very upsetting for the other mothers who come to the nursery to feed their babies.
Of course. Tell me, Mrs. Tingley, what time did you notice the baby missing?
At about 4 o'clock when he was due for his next shot.
Susan noticed he was missing. We checked everywhere, and I called Mrs. Tingley.
Did any of you check on the child at the start of your shift?
No, there was no reason to. The nurses on the evening shift gave him a shot at 12 o'clock, and he gets a shot every 4 hours.
And neither of you noticed anything unusual on your shift?
No. We were shocked to find out he was gone.
Okay. Thank you.
Excuse me, Mr. Thatcher. There's a reporter from WKWS-TV and two from the Middleton Leader downstairs in the lobby. They want to talk to you.
Tell them I'll see them in a few minutes. Nancy, wait. Yes, Thatcher here. Give me the Robarts room, will you, please?
I think Dr. Hereford is going to release Mrs. Robarts.
Yeah, what's the room number up there? Okay, thanks. Listen, Nancy, get up to the Robarts room. It's 421. Try and stop the Robarts and Dr. Hereford from leaving through the lobby. I don't want them to run into those jerks from the press. And have Dr. Hereford join me here.
Okay.
How's the sound, Bob?
Then? Afternoon.
Mr. Thatcher, we understand that a baby is missing from the nursery.
Well, needless to say, this has taken us completely by surprise. We're all absolutely shocked.
Do you feel the reputation of the hospital has been damaged by this?
No, we've always provided and will continue to provide the best medical care in Brewers County. But I think you'll agree this is a rather isolated incident.
Dr. Hereford, Mr. Thatcher insists that you use the physician's elevator.
Seems we're going to use the physician's elevator. It's just down this way.
Why?
Mr. Thatcher, I understand the baby was not healthy. Is that correct?
There were some problems, yes.
If the baby was receiving medical treatment, wouldn't his life be in danger now?
Oh, well, I'm afraid I couldn't comment on that. Perhaps Dr. Hereford, you could comment on this, please? The general health of the Robarts baby?
Yes. Yes. Last Sunday night, a young married Caucasian woman gave birth to...
Such a beautiful baby. I wish I could keep him for myself.
Oh, now, Eddie Helen, don't you think his mother will miss him? Anyway, she'll have a fit if she finds out you want to keep him here forever.
No, she'll be happy. Because you made him well again.
Yeah. Look, Aunt Helen, I'm going to work now, okay? Now, I don't want you to answer the phone, and I don't want you to talk to anybody about the baby, all right? Do you understand?
No, I won't talk to nobody.
Okay. Because it's just a big secret between you, me, and Barry, right? So you don't talk to anybody about the baby.
You don't have to tell me again.
Now, you really caught me by surprise with your candor out there.
Do you remember what you said this morning?
No, what?
Why would anyone in their right mind take a sick, retarded child from the nursery?
What?
Well, I'll tell you why. Some fanatic is out to get me. That's why. I've spent 12 years in obstetrics, and my opinion professionally is as good, if not better, than anyone's. And if I hadn't come straight out and stated the facts as I see them now, then I'm the one who ends up being the goat later. This way, it'll be up to them to prove otherwise.
Well, we all have to look after ourselves. And if we don't, who will, Dr. Hereford?
That's right. And make our own choices, Mr. Thatcher.
Thank you. Now tell the truth. Don't you sometimes get these babies mixed up? Be honest now.
All the time.
You do.
Don't we, Joan?
Oh.
You must be Joan McWatters?
Yes.
I'm Detective Frank Sincroni. This is my partner, Detective Bill Davis.
Hi.
You may have heard that a baby was taken from the nursery last night.
Yeah. Oh, yes. I heard on my way up. Mm-hmm.
Well, we'd like to ask you a few questions, if you don't mind.
Sure, of course.
Can we go outside? Is that all right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is this okay?
It's fine, now, Miss McWatters, I hope you can help us with this. We're not having much success so far.
Oh, please, call me Joan. That Ms. stuff, I don't know.
Yeah, me too. I'm glad you feel that way. I never know how to pronounce it. All right, Joan. I'll tell you, we're having a real hard time getting a handle on this. So, on your shift last night, did you see anyone, a man, a woman, a teenager, anyone at all, who looked like they had no business on the floor?
Well, I don't really recall seeing anybody up here who didn't have any business here. Mind you, a lot of people come and go. Actually, we're really too busy to notice everybody who's coming and going.
Is there any reason why someone would want to take that robot's baby from the nursery?
You mean the linen room?
Oh, yeah, the linen room.
I don't know, unless somebody thought they could help the child. I'm only guessing, of course.
Help how?
I'm giving him an operation.
An operation? But I thought the baby was dying, isn't that correct?
Well, yeah, but he's dying because he needs an operation. But his doctor and his parents decided against it.
Yeah, there was a court hearing on that, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That court order not to operate must have come as a real shock to you and to the other nurses. I
well, we all thought it was terrible, especially since it's such a simple one.
Oh?
I'm sorry, I'm only a nurse. I really shouldn't have said that.
What do you mean about the operation being a simple one?
Yeah. Well, nurses aren't supposed to comment on procedures to patients or relatives or anybody. Doctors get pretty uptight if we do that.
Well, I'm not a doctor.
Neither am I.
You can tell us. How simple an operation would you say this is, really?
Well, you can do it in a doctor's office under a local anesthetic.
Really? What would you do?
Well, you make the incision, cut the obstruction, and sew it up again.
That's it?
Yeah.
You really make it sound easy. Getting back to last night for a minute, are you sure you didn't see or notice anything that could be of some help to us?
No, sorry.
What about the parking lot?
No.
Well, thank you very much for your time, Ms. McWatters. Joan.
Yeah, right.
I guess that's it for now.
Okay, thank you.
By the way, did you ever work in OR?
No, I've always worked in the nursery. Why?
Oh, I just wondered. I thought I recognized you. I was in here for a kidney stone operation last year.
Yeah, I know, it wasn't me. Sorry.
Okay, thanks bye-bye. Again. Well, what'd you think of that?
Not bad.
I was referring to her brains. For someone who's never worked in an operating room, she certainly knows a hell of a lot.
That still doesn't make her a surgeon.
No, but it does make a very nice assistant.
Bingo.
Hank.
Uh-huh.
Why would anyone take our baby from the hospital?
I don't know.
You think we did the right thing?
Oh, yes. Absolutely, yeah.
Then why didn't that other doctor, you know, Dr.
Nicholson?
Why didn't she agree with Dr. Herford?
Because she's a mechanic. She doesn't look past the operation. She doesn't see the quality of life she's saving that child for.
I can't eat anymore.
The
parents and the doctor, however, wanted no heroic measures taken and decided against the operation. In a subsequent hearing, Judge Cooper ruled in favor of the parents. Late last night, after an extensive search, Baby Doe was reported missing from the nursery in the hospital. The police are investigating.
That ought to keep them nice and warm.
Aunt Helen, can you keep this up? We'll be getting a job at the hospital.
Very.
Joan goes home. Oh. That's very interesting. Look at that.
MD plates?
Right. That's right. I think we can do a little check on this.
Sure bet.
Dispatch, this is 274.
Now tell me again.
Okay, there's a phone booth right across the street from the ambulance station. We put the baby in the booth, we call the station, we move down the street, we make sure they pick him up, and then we take off.
Wonderful. Just like in the movies.
Well, it'll work, believe me. Damn it, better work.
So we get a chance, I want to phone my wife. Before I left tonight, my daughter was going out to her first high school dance, 14 and a half years old. She looked real pretty.
Growing up, man.
Yeah, she's getting there.
You're getting old, man.
License CED 93D5 belongs to Dr. Barry Rainsworth. Roger, dispatch, over. Well, I think we should pay them a little visit, huh?
Okay. Okay, Barry, turn right at the next set of lights. No, not here, the next set of lights. Sorry.
Now where?
Well, oh God, I don't believe this. Look, Barry, just turn right and go back two blocks. I think what we do, we miss the left-hand turn.
These guys?
Barry, those are cops.
Good evening.
Hi.
Are you Dr. Barry Reed?
Yep.
Police, Dr. Reed. I'm Detective Frank Sincroni.
Wasn't speeding.
No, no. Matter of fact, you're a very good driver. Miss McGuire's?
Hello.
Mind if I still call you Joan?
Be my guest.
Going bowling, Joan?
No, we're going to the hospital.
We're on our way to Middleton Memorial with an infant that's recently undergone surgery and needs to be admitted right away.
I understand. You better come with us.
Here.
Okay. Be careful.
He's all right.
Let's go.
Name, please.
Baby John Doe.
Address, please.
Address unknown.
Date.
Three and a half days.
Parents or guardian?
Guardian Barry Reed.
It's Barry Reed, M.D. Please sign over here, Dr. Reed.
With pleasure.
Thank you.
We won't be long.
Okay.
How about a kiss? Thank you. Hello. Yes. I'll be right there. Thank you. They found him. Somebody has done an operation on him. I can't believe this.
Upset about the baby. They can fix him, can't they?
Well, the baby's very sick, honey. And I don't think the doctors can make him better. Now eat up your breakfast.
Mommy, we told it. Does that mean we don't love him?
Oh, honey. It's okay.
Come on, guys, relax. The prosecutor dropped all charges. Why get uptight now? Don't know how lucky you are. You should be out dancing in the street. It's all very well, Dave, but we still have to face that hearing this afternoon. So what? It's only a contempt of court hearing. It isn't the end of the world. Barry, you worry too much. You know that?
There you go. The incision isn't a millimeter larger than necessary. Too bad the circumstances weren't a little more congenial for him.
Oh, I don't think it bothered him any. Barry seems to thrive under pressure.
Yeah, well, in the circumstances, that's just as well.
Dr. Nicholson, there's a call for you. They say it's urgent.
Excuse me.
Hello?
Oh, hello, Dr. Nicholson. Hi, this is Joe McWaters calling. You may have heard that there's going to be a contempt of court hearing this afternoon at 2 o'clock. Well, our lawyer, David Young, would like to know if you could be a witness for us.
Well, Jonah, I'm not sure if I can do that. You see, I truthfully don't know what the legal ramifications might be in a case such as this.
Listen, Dr. Nicholson, I'm going to give you our lawyer, David Young, okay? I think he can explain it better than I can, okay? Hang on just a sec.
Good morning, Dr. Nicholson. I have in front of me a transcript of the court hearing held last Monday. At that time, you stated that you considered this particular operation nothing more than a standard routine medical procedure. Is that correct?
I tell you what really gets me, it's this blatant, arrogant attitude. I mean, no regard for me, let alone the courts that go and they operate on this helpless vegetable. God, that kid doesn't have a chance in this world. Now, what kind of people are we dealing with here? Who in their right mind would do something like this?
Fine. All I want from you is to attest to that fact again this afternoon. Nothing more. Thank you.
Yeah?
She'll be there.
Oh.
Oh, she's not too happy, of course, but she'll be there.
Well? Valerie, doctor, I would like the chart and the wick. I'm Judy Robarts. I want to see my baby, please. Yes, of course. Please follow. How is he? Well, I think he's doing just fine. Would you like to... How serious was the operation? Mrs. Roberts, I'm sorry. I'm really not qualified to answer that question. I think you ought to talk to a doctor. Do to my baby. Can you tell me that, please?
Your child was operated on for an incarcerated hernia, Mrs. Robarts.
Is he all right now?
Well, you are aware, of course, Mrs. Robarts, that your child is suffering from Down syndrome. This condition is permanent.
I know that, but I want to know about the operation. Was it successful?
Mrs. Robarts, I'm not the child's physician. I'm sure you can appreciate that I really can't comment on your child's condition.
Why can't you just be straightforward with me?
If you just try and understand, please, Mrs. Robarts, under the circumstances, I really can't honestly comment on your child's condition.
What circumstances are you talking about? Now, you have no right to hide things from me.
I'm not trying to hide anything.
I am the baby's mother. You have no right to hide things from me. I want to know.
Your Honor, since by their own admittance, two employees of Middleton Memorial Hospital, namely resident surgeon Barry Reed and registered nurse Joan McWaters, have performed an operation on the Robarts infant without prior consent of the Robarts. And since this is counter to court order GU-8204-004, issued by this court last Monday, November 27th, we request the court to make a ruling in this case, namely to find them in contempt of court and punish or fine them for violating the court order and causing extreme mental and emotional hardship for the complainant and his family.
You may proceed, Mr. Meese.
Thank you, Your Honor. I'd like to call the father of the infant, Mr. Hank Robarts, to the stand.
Your right hand on the Bible, please. Do you solemnly swear that the testimony you're about to give is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Mr. Robarts, were you fully aware of all of the ramifications of Dr. Herford's recommended course of treatment for your son?
Yes, I was.
And you were in agreement?
Yes, I was.
Would you please reiterate for the court how you and your wife came to make that decision to follow Dr. Herford's course of treatment?
Well, in arriving at this decision, my wife and I put not only the best interests of the infant at heart, but also the emotional well-being of our family. We were advised that a minimally acceptable quality of life was not present for the child. And by going against our wishes, the defendants have doomed a helpless infant to a meaningless existence. They've placed a heavy emotional burden and a financial burden and the rest of my family. This is something I wouldn't wish for the child or myself or for anyone else for that matter.
Thank you, Mr. Roberts. You're a witness, Mr. Young.
No questions, Your Honor.
In that case, Your Honor, I'd like to call Dr. James Herford to the stand, please.
raise your right hand, please. Do you solemnly swear that the testimony you're about to give is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do so swear.
Thank you.
Dr. Herford, did you examine the Robarts infant at the hospital this morning?
Yes, I did.
Would you please tell the court what your findings were?
The severely retarded infant had been operated on for an incarcerated hernia.
Was this operation part of your recommended course of treatment for the retarded infant?
Definitely not. This operation was counter to my recommended course of treatment for the infant and definitely against the wishes of the parents and the court.
Thank you, Dr. Herford. Your witness, Mr. Young.
Dr. Herford, could you please tell the court how the child is doing now after the operation?
Objection, Your Honor. The present condition of the infant is totally irrelevant to this hearing. It has no bearing whatsoever on the question of whether the defendants are guilty of contempt of court or not.
Objection sustained.
Dr. Herford, please correct me if I'm mistaken, but I've been led to believe that the course of treatment you prescribed consisted basically of keeping the child comfortable and free of pain.
Yes, that's correct.
And did your course of treatment accomplish that?
Yes, it did.
Then why was the child constantly screaming and crying?
If that were the case, it certainly wasn't brought to my attention.
Were you not aware, as the child's physician, that the child was kept not in the nursery, but in a dirty linen room? Because
objection.
No one on the nursing staff could stand his constant crying because
Your
the
Honor.
Child was suffering from lack of nourishment. Do you call that treatment, Dr. Herford?
Objection, no, Your Honor. Dr. Herford is not on trial here. This is a hearing. I strongly object to Counsel Young's continuous badgering of my witness.
Mr. Young, if it is your intention of turning this hearing into a spectacle, then I will warn you now, I will not tolerate any more of your emotional outbursts.
Yes, Your Honor. Dr. Herford, you stated earlier that the child was severely retarded. Just how did you come to that conclusion?
Well, the child was born with Down syndrome, and this condition can be detected immediately after birth by a visual observation. My findings were later confirmed by other physicians.
I see. Now, the extent of the retardation, how did you determine that?
Well, extent is really a matter of conjecture at this stage.
Did you determine that the child was 10% retarded, 50% retarded, 70% retarded?
No, we didn't.
Why didn't you, Doctor?
Because there's no way of telling, nor can we determine the extent to which the genetic blueprint has been scrambled at this stage in human development.
Then what you're saying, if I understand you correctly, is that only time will tell.
Yes, if you like.
Then how can you talk of a severe retardation when, in fact, right now, you don't know the extent of it?
Well, short of using the term mongoloid baby, every physician has his own way of interpreting the visual evidence as it presents itself.
Let me run this by you slowly, Dr. Herford. What may seem severe retardation to you could very well be mild retardation to another physician at this early stage, yes or no?
As I said before, extent is really a matter of conjecture.
No further questions, Your Honor.
You solemnly swear that the testimony you're about to give is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Dr. Reed, when did you perform the operation on the child?
At 4 a.m. Wednesday morning.
And what did you operate on the child for?
For an incarcerated hernia.
Is that a serious operation, doctor?
No, not at all. It's normally considered routine minor surgery performed under a local anesthetic.
I see. Now, if it's, as you say, just routine minor surgery, why did you have to operate in the middle of the night? Could it not have waited till the morning?
Well, by then, the child was already 3 days old. The hernia condition now stood a good chance of turning gangrenous and becoming life-threatening to the child.
In other words, if you had not operated on the child then and there, the hernia condition would have grown more and more serious, causing the child eventually to die.
That's correct.
Why didn't you tell me that before, Hank?
No, he's exaggerating. It's just not that simple.
Last Monday, the parents obtained a court order ordering the hospital not to go ahead with a planned operation on the infant. Well, a doctor and a nurse did operate on the severely retarded infant, and so the court must now decide whether the doctor and the nurse are in contempt. As you can see from the signs behind me, not everyone is in agreement with the parents or the court.
Thank you. Your witness, Mr. Meese.
I have no questions, Your Honor.
In that case, Your Honor, I would now like to call on Joan McWaters to take the stand, please.
Place your right hand, please. Do you solemnly swear that the testimony you're about to give is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Thank you.
Ms. McWaters, how long have you been a nurse at Middleton Memorial Hospital?
4 years.
And how long have you been working in the nursery?
Almost 3.5 years.
In dealing with your patients, do you always follow doctor's orders?
Yes, always.
Then what made you decide, a nurse who always follows doctor's orders, to interfere in this particular child's treatment?
Because I couldn't stand to see him suffer any longer.
You couldn't stand to see him suffer. Now, Dr. Herford prescribed a course of treatment that consisted basically of keeping the child comfortable and free of pain. Yet you say the child suffered. Why?
Well, he wasn't allowed fluid or nourishment of any kind.
Please speak up. We can't hear you.
He wasn't allowed fluid or nourishment of any kind.
Why wasn't the child allowed any fluids or nourishment?
Objection, Your Honor. The course of treatment decided on by the parents is not under dispute here. Counsel Young's line of questioning is totally irrelevant to the hearing.
Your Honor, I'm attempting to establish the defendant's motivation for interfering in the child's treatment. I think it has a direct bearing on this hearing.
Objection overruled. Please proceed, Mr. Young.
Now, Ms. McWaters, why did it upset you so much, the child not receiving any food or any water?
Well, because they just wanted to let him go.
Please speak up. We can't hear you.
Because they wanted him to die.
No, that's not true! Oh, I was never told anything like that. Nobody asked me. I didn't want my baby to die like that. I'm the child's mother, Your Honor. I want my baby.
Do you have any more big binders for this box?
Yeah, there's some here.
You want me to get that?
Yeah.
Hi. These are for you.
For me?
Isn't this 127?
Yeah.
From Parkinson's, ma'am.
Oh, thanks. Bye. What would you have to do that for?
I didn't.
Well, who are they from, do you suppose?
Beats me.
Roses. Look at this. Thank you both for taking good care of me at a time when I needed it most. I'm doing well. My mother and sister tell me they love me. Someday I hope my father will feel that way too. Love, baby John Doe.